Hello dear students, welcome back to chemistry classes. Today you have to know some important terms in coordination chemistry. Let us go, what are those? Coordination entity or complex ion. What is this meaning? It is nothing but coordination entity or complex ion is nothing but a central metal atom. It is surrounded by number of ligands which are arranged in a definite geometrical arrangement. See, for example, a complex in which central metal atom is surrounded by group of molecules which are arranged in a definite geometrical shape. Definite geometrical shape. For example, FeCN6 3+. I am writing this in the definite geometrical arrangement. Ferrous is a central metal atom. It is surrounded by how many groups? CN groups? 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. CN. Okay, like this it is arranged, means 3 plus ions are on outside. It carries the charges here. That's why it is a central metal atom. These are the group of molecules. These group of molecules donates a pair of electrons to central metal atom and form a coordinate bond. This type of compounds are called complex ions or complex compounds, coordination compounds. Got it? Okay. Next term is complex. I'm writing like this. K4 FeCN6 plus 2, isn't it? Then here whatever the elements or group of atoms present in the square bracket, this square bracket is known as coordination sphere. This square bracket is known as what? Coordination sphere. When it is dissolved in solution, it remains as it is, same. That's why this is a coordination sphere. Same thing, plus 2. It is a coordination sphere. the atoms or ion which is present outside the coordination sphere is called counter ion. Counter ion. The atoms or ions which are present outside the coordination sphere is called counter ion. The central metal atom and ligands which are enclosed by square bracket is called coordination sphere. I'm repeating, what do you mean by coordination sphere? Coordination sphere is nothing but the central metal atom and this group of atoms enclosed in square bracket, it is called coordination sphere. I'm repeating, this is the coordination complex K4 Fe into bracket Fe CN 6 plus 2. It is a coordination sphere. Sorry, not writing the ion here. It is a coordination sphere. In coordination sphere, what are there? Central metal atom and ligands. What we call ligands? What do you mean by ligands? It is a central metal atom and it is a ligand. The central metal atom and group of atoms enclosed in a square bracket. It is a square bracket. In this, what are there? Central metal atom and ligands are group of atoms enclosed in a square bracket. This square bracket is known as what? Coordination sphere. Whatever the elements or ions or group of molecules present outside the coordination sphere, it is called counter ion. Then what do you mean by central metal atom? What do you mean by central metal atom? What do you mean by central metal atom? Central metal atom is nothing but what? A metal ion which is surrounded by group of atoms, or it is also nothing but ligands. Group of atoms, a metal ion which is surrounded by group of atoms, such type of metal ions are called central metal ions. Similarly, ligands, what do you mean by ligands? Ligands are nothing but atom or group of atoms. Atom or group of atoms which can donate pair of electrons to central metal atom. See, in the coordination compounds, it is a coordination sphere. What do you mean by coordination sphere? Coordination sphere is nothing but central metal atom and ligands or group of atoms which is enclosed in a square bracket. It is called coordination sphere. The atoms or ions which is present outside the coordination sphere is called counter ion. Then what do you mean by central metal atom? Central metal atom is nothing but a metal ion which is surrounded by number of ligands. which is surrounded by number of ligands and receive pair of electrons or accept pair of electrons. This central metal atom receives or accepts a pair of electrons from the ligands. It is called what? Central metal atom. Then these are the ligands. Ligands are nothing but what? A group of atoms. Atom or a group of atoms which donates the pair of electrons. To central metal atom. It is called ligands. Got it? Okay. Types of complexes. Depending upon the charge present on the complex, they are categorized into three types. One is cationic complex. Cationic complex is what? A complex ion which is having a positive charge on their complex. It is called cationic complex. For example, nickel 3 plus, then Cl2 NH3 plus charge, 4. These are what? Any complexes which are having a positive charge on their complex are called cationic complex. Then anionic complex. What do you mean by anionic complex? Complexes which are having a negative charge on their complex is called anionic complexes. Neutral complex. What do you mean by neutral complex? Neutral complex are nothing but the complex which not having any charges on their complexes are called neutral complexes. Next, platinum CoCl3NH3 trace. These are what? Neutral complexes. Remember, complexes which carries positive charge, it is called cationic complexes. Complexes which carrying the negative charge, it is called anionic complexes. Complexes which carrying neither positive nor negative charges or zero charges is called what? Neutral complexes. These type of complexes are categorized based on what? Based on charges. They can be classified based on charges. Okay. Next concept, classification of complexes based on ligands. Remember, based on ligands. Based on ligands, they can be classified into two. Based on ligands, they can be complex. Complexes are classified into two types. One is homoleptic complex and heteroleptic complex. Hetero लेप्टिक हेटरोलेप्टिक कॉम्प्लेक्स, हेटरोलेप्टिक कॉम्प्लेक्स। देन व्हाट यू मीन बाय होमोलेप्टिक कॉम्प्लेक्स? होमो मीन्स सेम, होमो मीन्स व्हाट? सेम, होमो मीन्स सेम, होमोलेप्टिक। लेप्टिसिटी मीन्स they are having a only one type of ligands, a complex in which central metal atom is surrounded by a complex in which central metal atom is surrounded by only one type of ligands called homoleptic. For example, nickel tetracarbonyl, then ferrous hexacyanide, cobalt hexamine, like this compounds, the complexes having a similar type means all are carbonyl, all cyanide, all are what? Amines. Like this similar kinds, same type of ligands are surrounded by central metal atom, such type of complexes are called homoleptic complexes. It is very important for 2 marks or 1 marks. Then what do you mean by heteroleptic complexes? Heteroleptic, hetero means different, hetero means different one another, different from one another. Then what is the definition of this complexes? I am repeating, homoleptic, a complex in which central metal atom is surrounded by only one type of ligands are called homoleptic ligands. The heteroleptic complexes means different. I'm altering the definition of homoleptic. That is a complex in which a central metal atom is surrounded by more than one type of ligands. For example, one type of ligands are called heteroleptic complex. For example, ferrous Cl2 CN4. In this, the central metal atom is surrounded by chlorine and cyanide, two types of ligands. For example, cobalt, chlorine, 4. Like this, nickel, bromine, Br2, NH3 twice. Like this, different types of ligands, more than one type of ligands. Such type of complexes are called heteroleptic complexes. Heteroleptic complexes means what? A complex in which a central metal atom is surrounded by more than one type of complexes are called what? Heteroleptic complexes. Got it? Types of ligands. Types of ligands. Ligands are classified based on the number of electrons donates to the central metal atom. If a ligand or group of atom donates only one pair of electrons to the central metal atom, if a ligand is donates only one pair of electron to the central metal atom, it is called mono or unidentate. If a ligand donates two lone pair of electrons to the central metal atom, it is called bidentate ligands. If a ligand donates three lone pair of electrons, it is called tridentate ligands. If a ligand donates more than three lone pair of electrons, it is called polydentate ligand. Polydentate ligands. Or if a ligand which can donate, which are having two donor atoms but can ligate only one atom, either N or either C, it is called ambidentate ligands. Like that, ligands are classified into four. Those are monodentate ligands, bidentate ligands, directly I am writing polydentate ligands or ambidentate ligands. What do you mean by this ligate or dentate? Denticity. Okay, what do you mean by this denticity? Denticity is nothing but what? Number of atoms which can form the coordination bonds to the central metal atom. Number of atoms forms coordination bonds. Number of atoms forms a coordination bonds. Got it? What do you mean by this denticity means? For example, a ligand which is having only one donor atom, it forms only one coordination bond, it is called monodentate. If it is having a two pair to the central metal atom, it is called bidentate. If it is three, tridentate. If it is more than three, polydentate. Like that, the denticity is defined. Okay, monodentate ligands. Let us go one by one. Types of ligands. Monodentate ligand definition. The ligand which can donate only one lone pair of electrons. Ligands the ligand which can donate only one lone pair of electrons, electron to central metal atom, to central metal atom, to central metal atom. Remember the things. If a central metal atom, one condition is there, central metal atom must have vacant d orbitals, vacant d orbitals, vacant orbitals, and it is referred as Lewis acid. Lewis acid, it is referred as Lewis acid, and ligands are referred as a base. Base, Lewis base or Bronsted base. Ligands referred as a Bronsted base, and central metal atom referred as a Lewis acid. It has to vacant orbital. It has to lone pair of electrons. Lone pair of electrons. Then only the complex forms, complex formation favors. Okay. Then here again, monodentate ligands are classified into what? Negative ligands. Negative ligands. Negative ligands. And positive ligands. Positive ligands. Positive ligands. And neutral ligands. Neutral ligands. Neutral ligands. Negative ligands like Cl minus, when it goes into the nomenclature, it is called a chlorido. Chlorido. Bromine, bromido. Bromido. Iodine, why we call like this? When we going go through the nomenclature in the coordination compounds, we remove the iodide, chloride, chlorido, like this. Oh, last bromide, bromido, like that. Have to remove the last terminal and add the O suffix. Okay, see, iodide, iodide means iodide. Cyanate, Fluorido. This is the poor acetic acid, acetate. For acetic acid, acetate. For so many are there, I will give the notes, or when in the nomenclature, I will tell. Deep for positive, nitronium. For NO, nitrosonium. For neutral ligands, carbonyl are the neutral ligands. Aqua, for carbonyl, aqua, amines, these are all what? Neutral ligands. For monodentate or unidentate, it is also called unidentate. Also unidentate ligands or monodentate ligands. Next one, bidentate ligands. Bidentate ligands. Second one, by or di dentate ligands. Di dentate ligands. Atoms are group of molecules which can donate two lone pair of electrons to a central metal atom forming the coordination bond. These are called bidentate or didentate ligands. For example, oxalate ion. This is an oxalate ion. It is having two denticity. Amines. Ethane want to diamine. These are all what? Ethane, oxalate ion. Abbreviated form we can write OX abbreviated form like that. Ethane want to diamine. For this abbreviated form is what? En. These are having a one lone pair of electrons each. Okay, this is a bidentate ligands. Next one is tridentate ligands. Same polydentate. Directly I'm writing the polydentate ligand. Polydentate ligand. What do you mean by this polydentate ligand? Polydentate ligand is nothing but atom or group of atom which can donate the more than two lone pair of electrons to the central metal atom. It is called polydentate ligand. Okay, what are the polydentate ligands example? Ligand which can donate. Can donate two or more than two pair of electrons to central metal atom. It is called polydentate ligands. For example, EDTA. What do you mean by this EDTA? This is for ethylene. This is what? Ethylene diamine. How many? Tetraacetate. Acetic acid is, there are four acetic acids are there. Acetate ion. EDTA, ethylene diamine tetraacetate. These are having a denticity 6. 6 donating atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is having a denticity 6. There are 6 dentate elements are there. Okay. Like that, polydentate ligands are there. Next one is ambidentate ligands. What do you mean by this ambidentate ligand? ambidentate ligand means ambidentate ligand, a ligand which can donate more than two donor atoms, a ligand which have two donor atoms, two or more than two, two donor atoms, a ligand which have two or more than two donor atoms, but ligate only one donor atom. Ligate through only one donor atom. Only one donor atom. For example, it is a metal CN, methyl cyanide. Same thing, it is a metal. It is linked by, here it is linked by N, here it is linked by C. Similarly, same thing happens in isocyanate and thiocyanate. It is linked by S, here it is linked by N. Similarly, it is a metal, it is linked by nitro group. Here ligating atom is nitrogen, here ligating atom is oxygen. The ligand which are having two or more than two donor atoms, but ligate through only one donor atom, it is called ambidentate ligands. Next, coordination number. What do you mean by coordination number? Coordination number is nothing but number of ligands which can form a coordination bonds to the central metal atom. It is called coordination number. For example, Fe coordination number. Coordination number. For example, FeCN6. Any 3 plus in this complex, coordination number is 6. Ferrous ion, it is surrounded by how many? 6 Cn. Ions. So it forms the complex. It forms what? Complexes. Got it? It is what? Coordination number. For another example, ferrous, it is surrounded by OX, means oxalic acid. How many coordination bonds are there? Ferrous, it contains EN, OX. OX means it donates two lone pair of electrons. OX. It also forms the how many? 1, 2, 3, 4. The coordination number is 4. Like that, you have to form. Next, chelation. Next concept is chelation. What do you mean by this chelation? Chelation is nothing but the ring complexes. For example, chelation. A central metal atom, it is surrounded by bidentate or polydentate ligands. Surrounded by bidentate or polydentate ligands, which forms the ring complexes. Such type of ring complexes is known as what? Chelation. What do you mean by chelation? A complex in which a polydentate ligand donates pair of electrons forms what? Complexes. Such type of complexes are called chelating complexes. Chelating complex. Then what do you mean by chelating agent? A bidentate or polydentate ligand which ligates through the central metal atom to form a ring structure, ring complexes. Such type of complexes are called chelating complex. Such type of ligands are called chelating ligands. Got it? Okay. For example, EDTA. EDTA is a central metal atom. Any central metal atom. EDTA means ethylene diamine. Ethylene diamine. One nitrogen group is there. This nitrogen group having two. This nitrogen group also having two. Means here one bond is there. One bond. Here CH2, C double bond O. Another bond. Here CH2, C double bond O, another bond. Similarly, here CH2, C double bond O, another bond. CH2, C double bond O, another bond. Like this, six bond and six ring complexes. Ring complexes are called 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six. Like that. Rings are formed. This type of complexes are called chelating complexes. Got it? Okay. We'll continue in next class.